Here in our topics of thermodynamics, we're going to talk about the PV diagram, and in particular, the work done by gas as illustrated on the PV diagram. So first of all, what is a PV diagram? Well, a PV diagram is a diagram that has pressure on the vertical axis, volume on the horizontal axis. On the PV diagram, you will place points which represent the state of a gas. So for example, a gas will start at state 1 that has pressure 1 and volume 1, in this case 2 cubic meters and 1 atmosphere, and then through a series of changes it'll end up in a different state with a different volume and a different pressure. And then the question is, how much work was done by the gas? Well, it could be a negative quantity if work is done on the gas, but that is a topic for later. So notice that in the first example here and the second example, in both cases, the beginning state and the end state are the same. The gas just gets there in a different way. Here, first the gas is expanded in volume and then the pressure is increased. In this case, the pressure is increased first and then the volume is expanded. How much work is done in each case? And how can we figure it out more easily using the diagram? And finally, to illustrate it even more so, here we have a case where we go directly from state 1 to state 3 and in diagonal line like that. And what is the work done in that case? Well, let's start with what we know. In this case, we can say that the total work done from going from 1 to 3 is equal to the work done from going from 1 to 2, and then plus the work done in going from 2 to 3. Now right away we should realize that when we go from 2 to 3, since the volume of the gas doesn't change, work done should automatically be 0. So in this case we can say, well, this quantity is 0, so the total work done is simply the work done going from 1 to 2. And since in this case the pressure doesn't change, remember in that case it is equal to the pressure times the change in the volume, so in this case the pressure is equal to P1, and the change in the volume is V2 minus V1, the difference in the volumes of those two. So in this case the pressure is 1 atmosphere, which is 101,300 pascals or newtons per square meter, multiplied times the change in the volume, which the end volume is 5 cubic meters, the beginning volume is 2 cubic meters. So that means we multiply 101,300 pascal, which is atmospheric pressure, times the difference in the volume, which is 3 cubic meters, and that would give us a total of 3 times that would be 303,900, and pascals times cubic meters, remember, a pascal is a newton per square meter, and we multiply that times cubic meters, so this would be newton meters, and of course a newton meter is a joule, so that would be 303,900 joules. Now in the second example, we first let the pressure increase and then we increase the volume. So here again, we can say that the total work done is equal to the work done in going from 1 to 4 plus the work done in going from 4 to state 3. But again, in this case, going from 1 to 4, the volume doesn't change. So if the volume doesn't change, no work can be done, and that is equal to 0. So the total work done is simply equal to the work done in going from 4 to 3. Now, this is equal to, we're going down from 4 to 3, is the pressure at 4 times the volume change, volume of 3 minus the volume at 4. So in this case, the pressure is 3 atmospheres, which is 303,900 pascals, times the change in the volume, which is, again, 5 cubic meters minus 2 cubic meters. So from 2 to 5, so the difference is three cubic meters. So it'll be 3 times this. So this is equal to 909,000. So that would be 911,700. And that would, of course, again be joules. Pascal times cubic meters, of course, is newton meters or joules. Notice that the work done here is 3 times as much as the work done because the pressure was 3 times as much and we had the same volume change. Now I would like you to notice something else. Imagine this triangle right here. What is the area of this triangle? Well, the area of this triangle is equal to the length times the height. The height is the pressure, and the length is the change in the volume. So in other words, on a PV diagram, the work done is simply equal to the area underneath any arrow representing a change of state. When we go from state 1 to state 2, the arrow is drawn right here. The area underneath this, the area underneath this arrow, tongue twist there, is equal to dP times delta V, which is the work done. Here, the area underneath this curve is much greater because the arrow is much higher up, but again, the area is the height times the width. The height would be the pressure, 3 atmosphere, the width would be the change in the volume. So again, the area underneath the curve here represents the work done by that change of state. Notice that the vertical arrow has no area underneath it, so that really doesn't give us any work done. So now when we go over here, when we realize that going from state 1 to state 3, the pressure does not stay the same, so we cannot use our equation that work done is pressure times change in volume. But we do know that the work done is always equal to the area underneath this curve. So what we can say is, if we find out what the area is of this rectangle, and then we find out what the area is of this triangle, we can actually figure out the work done in this process by simply adding up the area of this rectangle plus the area of the triangle. So the work done is equal to the area of the rectangle plus the area of the triangle. The area of the rectangle is simply height times width. The height is the pressure of 1 atmosphere. The width is the change in the volume, which is 3 cubic meters. So it would be 101,300 pascal, which is 1 atmosphere, multiplied times 3 meters cubed. So that would be the area of the rectangle, which represents the work done by this portion, plus the area of the triangle, which would be, let's see here, we have the height times the width. The height would be the difference in the pressure, would be 3 atmospheres minus 1 atmosphere, which is 2 atmospheres. 2 times 101,000 is 202,300, oh, not 300, but 600. We have to double everything, pascals. Times the change in the volume, and that would be the width. That would be, let's see here. So the height times the width. The width is 3 cubic meters. But now don't forget that this is a triangle, not a rectangle, so we have to take half of that. So we have to put a half in the front. It's 1/2 the width of the height. And so it's equal to that. In other words, this is equal to this times this. That would be equal to, let's see here, half times this, 101,000 times 3, that would be double that. That would be 606,000. I better grab a calculator because I don't think I did that exactly correctly. So we have 101,300 times 6 equals 607,800. That's what I thought. Slight error in there. That's better. Okay, so now you can see that you can actually calculate the work done by simply multiplying pressure times volume, or change in volume if the pressure doesn't change. Or you could simply take the area underneath the curve and find the work done that way. So, very nice addition to your repertoire on how to deal with this type of thermodynamics.